Okay, so we've talked a lot about recording multiple audio tracks in OBS Studio, but some of you have commented that when you import your recorded video file into a video editor, the audio tracks aren't there. Where did they go? How do you get them back? Today, we're going to show you a workaround for multiple audio tracks if your video editor doesn't like them. We're going to check it out right after this. The Elgato Cam Link takes your mirrorless, DSLR, GoPro, or camcorder and turns it into a higher quality face cam than any webcam could ever provide, without the hassle and headache of normal USB webcam drivers or their terrible settings configuration. Get an uncompressed, low latency 1080p 60 signal from your camera straight to your stream with this little device right here. Buy one via the link in the video description. I'm Meeples Vox, here to make tech easier and more fun, and welcome back to my OBS Studio tutorial course. I've got a lot of videos in this course in the playlist in the description below. In those videos, I probably answer most questions you have, so check them out if you have any questions, and check the intro video if you want to learn how this whole course works. First of all, super shout out to Sergeant Gaming, who put in a lot of time trying to answer people on the last OBS tutorial series with this answer. Thanks for fighting the good fight. His comment does actually encapsulate what you need to do to pull out multiple audio tracks from an OBS recorded file. First and foremost, you will need Audacity installed on your computer along with the FFmpeg plugin. These are linked in the video description below that like button. Both are free and Audacity is open source and works on all operating systems. Download and install Audacity, then run the FFmpeg plugin installer. If you recorded your video in OBS to an MKV file, you will need to use the File Remux Recordings menu in OBS to convert that to a usable MP4 file. Open Audacity and drag in your MP4 video file. Yes, you heard me right. Audacity will pop up this dialog box asking you to choose which audio track you want to import from the video. You will need to pick one and import it. Apply any audio editing or processing you wish to the clip, being careful not to change the length of the clip, or it will be a nightmare to line up with the video, and export as a WAV from the File menu. Repeat these steps for each desired audio track from your video recording. Then you have the original video with one track and individual audio WAV files to import into your video editor. Line them up and balance, and you're good to go. Since the video file should, ideally, import the first video track into your video editor regardless of the extras, I recommend putting your game sound as the first track. This way, it's always lined up with your video and ready to go. This is a tedious workaround, but it does still give you direct control over your audio files. Adobe CC 2014 and newer suites should support the multiple audio tracks with no problem from MP4 files generated by OBS Studio, but many other video editors fail to support this properly, as well as the older Adobe CS6 suite. I hope this episode of my OBS Studio tutorial course has been helpful for you. It was quick, but I really wanted to highlight this specific fix. If you liked it, hit the like button, subscribe for some more awesome tech videos here on the channel. If you like game streaming, come follow me on Twitch and say hi in chat. Until next time, I'm Meeples Vox. Happy streaming.
Thanks for watching this episode of my OBS Studio tutorial course. More videos like this and a full master class are linked in the playlist in the video description. Click to learn more. Also, consider joining us on Patreon to help keep tech education free. Go to patreon.com/eposvox to sign up.